Hello guys, welcome to another video of mine. I'm now at Southern Cross Station in Melbourne, Victoria. I'm about to catch V-Line NZ locomotive train to Wodonga, then connecting on to a V-Line coach to Canberra. This is my first time catching a regional train in Victoria. Is it gonna be a great experience? Let's go and find out now. Southern Cross Station is the second busiest railway station in Melbourne's metropolitan network. The station is a terminus of the state's regional railway network operated by V-Line, the Overland Rail service to Adelaide, and New South Wales TrainLink XPT service to Sydney. It is also served by suburban rail services operated by Metro Trains. The station has 16 platforms, with regional services from platforms 1 to 8 and suburban services from platforms 9 to 16. Platforms 2 to 7 as well as platforms 15 to 16 are numbered as two sections. Section A from the Collins Street Concourse to the Bourke Street Footbridge and Section B beyond the Bourke Street Footbridge. Platforms 1 and 2 are fitted with dual gauge track, permitting both standard gauge interstate trains and V-Line broad gauge trains. The remainder of the platforms are solely broad gauge. The service I'll be catching today is called Canberra Link, offered by V-Line. It includes a 3.5-hour train ride on the North East Railway line from Melbourne to Wodonga, then a 4.5-hour bus ride to the Jollymont Centre in Canberra City. The North East Railway line runs from Southern Cross Station to Albury Railway Station in the border settlement of Albury-Wodonga. Unlike other heavy rail lines in Victoria, the line is a completely standard gauge after gauge conversion works were carried out between 2008 and 2011. Three V-Line passenger locomotives and 15 passenger carriages were also converted to standard gauge to operate the service. The entire line is used by V-Line Albury Trains and New South Wales XPT. Today's service to Albury is operated by a standard gauge V-Line N-class locomotive. N464 City of Geelong entered service on 29th of September 1986. It has a maximum speed of 130 km per hour. Fitted with 6,800 litre fuel tanks, the class are capable of running from Melbourne to Adelaide without refuelling. Today, City of Geelong is hauling 5 N-type carriages to Albury. The 5 carriages consists of 3 economy class, 1 first class, and 1 luggage van.
Please do not board the train at platform 2B until further advised.
The train was scheduled to depart at 7:05. We were not allowed to board the train until 7:01. Before showing you the first class carriage, let's have a look at the economy class carriage. The economy class seats are in a 2-3 configuration. Following customer feedback, the seating arrangements were reorganized to place centers of back-to-back seats in line with pillars between windows. The seat has good amount of legroom when there's no one sitting face to face with you. If the train was full, the legroom would be very limited. Furthermore, the seats are not reclinable and there's no armrest between each seat. It must be really uncomfortable for the person sitting in the middle seat. The first class seats are in a 2-2 configuration. All seats face the direction of travel. The seat provides a good amount of legroom that I can fully stretch my leg. At the back of each seat, there's a massive tray table and a footrest. Compared to the economy class seat, this is wider and also offers a good degree of recline. All carriages on this train are air conditioned and have floor and air heating. There is an overhead luggage rack on both sides of the train and a luggage shelf at the end of each carriage. There is one unisex toilet on each carriage, along with hot water for each wash basin, fed from a 635-litre pressurized tank. There's a cafe on board for you to purchase food and drinks during the journey. It is temporarily unavailable due to health and safety regulations. However, the cafe is planned to reopen from the 31st of January 2021, accepting both cash and card payments. You can find the full cafe bar menu on V-Line's website. Between Melbourne and Seymour, the train runs express, stopping only at Broadmeadows station. After Seymour, the train stops at all stations to Albury. New South Wales XPT also runs two daily services from Melbourne to Albury, stopping at Broadmeadows, Seymour, Benalla and Wangaratta only. Here is a comparison of two services based on my personal experience. I got off the train at Wodonga station, just before the train crossed the border to Albury, New South Wales. The second half of the trip to Canberra is a coach ride operated by V-Line. The bus was already waiting for me outside the station.
Hello. Canberra?
Yeah.
Albury Wodonga is a broad settlement incorporating the twin cities of Albury and Wodonga. They are separated geographically by the Murray River and politically by a state border. Albury on the north of the river is part of New South Wales, while Wodonga on the south bank is in Victoria. After crossing the Murray River, we have entered New South Wales. The first stop is Albury. You can see the train that I caught earlier also just arrived here. After departing Albury, the bus entered M31 Hume Highway and is heading towards Canberra at 110 km/h. The bus is relatively clean. The seat has a good amount of legroom and it is reclinable. There is a toilet at the back of the bus. Mask is not mandatory to wear on public transport in regional New South Wales, therefore you can choose to take your mask off if you want. Between Albury and Canberra, the bus is scheduled to stop at Woomagama, Holbrook, Takata, Gundagai and Yass. At Gundagai, there is a 10-minute break, so you can look around and visit the Visitor Information Centre if you like.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're just coming up across the border from New South Wales into the ACT. So that puts us about 30 minutes away from our destination, which is the Jolimont Centre in Canberra Civic. So we're about 30 minutes away from our destination. Thank you.
This journey overall is quite smooth and pleasant. The bus arrived Canberra a few minutes ahead of schedule. There are a few options for travelling between Melbourne and Canberra. Both Qantas and Virgin Australia offer a number of direct flights per day between the two cities. Greyhound Australia operates a direct overnight bus service, and also New South Wales TrainLink offers a similar train plus coach service between Melbourne and Canberra. In my opinion, V-Line and New South Wales TrainLink offer the most affordable option. If you are a train enthusiast, I would recommend you to try both services. 8.5 hours on the train and bus may sound a bit long, but trust me, it's not as bad as it seems.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're only a couple of minutes away from our destination now. I just ask that before you get off the coach, can you please check, make sure you have all your property with you, particularly mobile phones, wallets, sunglasses. And I'd like to thank you for using guys the V-Line coach service from Wodonga to Canberra, and hope that it was comfortable. Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to give it a like if you have enjoyed it, and please subscribe to my channel for more train and aviation reviews. I'll see you guys in my next video.